much. Thank you. Okay, so I want you to imagine me, 11 years old, a couple inches shorter, some braces, and in my first day of school outfits. You know, I'm all ready for my first day of public school in America. I was homeschooled up until then, so I'm nervous. I'm you know, shaking a little bit, but I'm trying to play it cool. I walk to lunch and confidently sit down with a group of girls determined to make friends. I take out my lunch bag, open it up, and take out my cheese and onion sandwich, the thing I have been eating every day for my whole life. And all the other girls take out a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, something I'd never had before. Every single one of them has them, and if you know Americans, or if you are American, you know that peanut butter and jelly sandwiches are really big. So I asked them, I'm like, what's that? What are you having? And they're like, peanut butter jelly sandwich, obviously. And I say, oh, I've never had one before. And they're all like, that's really weird. You know, and my first day of school, people are already calling me weird. It wasn't really off to a great start, but that's okay. You know, it got better. So fast forward a couple years into my teenage year. So that was an example of when my Scottish upbringing, Scottish heritage, was a little more apparent to me. You know, nothing extreme, but there were a few instances in my life when it felt a little more obvious to me, and I felt a little bit out of place or weird, as some of my friends said. So fast forward a few years to my teenage years, and I constantly have this nagging feeling that something doesn't quite fit. You know, America did not feel like my real home. It was hard to explain. I wasn't sure where it came from, because America and Scotland really aren't that different. It's the same language, same style of living. You know, we have the same technology. But there was just something that didn't quite fit. So I thought, of course, that if I went back to Scotland, I would feel at home. It would be a perfect fit. It's where my roots were. That must be where I'm meant to be. So I went back, you know, a few times to visit my family who still live there, and I loved it. It was great. You know, though that was only for a week or two, but still, I thought it was great. And I was determined to find somewhere where I felt at home. So then, fast forward again to last September, and I arrive in Ukraine. I thought I knew what it felt like to not be at home. Then I come to Ukraine, and let me tell you that I really did not feel at home when I arrived. You know, I didn't know the language. You know, my clothes weren't warm enough. I had to figure out life cell, all this new stuff. It's kind of a mess. Yeah, I'm sure a lot of the other volunteers feel the same way when they arrived. So, you know, I'm in Ukraine for I've been in Ukraine for about a year now. A year of a lot of embarrassing mishaps, a lot of times where I did feel pretty weird and pretty out of place. And then I got the opportunity to go to Scotland last July over the summer. I was so excited. I was so excited to go somewhere that I felt normal again. You know, I was convinced that when I went, I would feel more at home. So I'm, you know, sitting in my apartment in Poltava, waiting to leave, eating my peanut butter and jelly sandwich, something I had many times since I was 11 in seventh grade, and I'm so excited to get to Scotland. The second I land, I just feel this wave of relief. I hear English all around me. You know, I can read the signs perfectly without second guessing myself, and it's great. For the first night, anyway. So I wake up the first morning, and I arrived late, so I hadn't done anything. So the next morning, I go down to the hotel lobby, the airport hotel, to take out money, which shouldn't have been a big deal. But I go over to the ATM, put in my card, and it goes, rejected. Can't get any money out. So I go, okay, that's fine. Try again. Okay. I start getting a little nervous. My American card is not working in this Scottish bank machine, and I can't use my Ukrainian phone to call anyone for help. So I'm, you know, standing there, getting nervous. I'm looking around, you know, there's a line of the behind me at the ATM. I'm like, oh, shoot. I'm freaking out. So then I think to myself, okay, I can do this. I live in Ukraine. I can do anything. and I speak the language here. I'll be fine. So I pull myself together and I think, okay, my aunt lives in the city. I'll get a taxi to take me to my aunt and she will help me out. So I walk out, I go over to the line of taxis and I go up to him and I explain the situation and he says, no problem, I can do that. So I say, great, can you take me to 24 Cadogan Street? And he's like, Cadogan Street? And I keep saying, like, I look at the address my aunt sent me. I'm like, yeah, 24 Cadogan Street. It's in the city center. And he's like, show me, show me. So I show him the address, and he goes, oh, 24 Cadogan Street. And I'm like, yeah, that one. And I'm like, oh, having flashbacks, you know, to taxis I take in Kyiv. And I'm like, oh, my gosh, it's the same thing. Showing them the map, like, toot. I need to go toot. So we're in the cab. It's fine. You know, he's like, you're not Scottish with that accent, are you? And I'm like, well, you know, I'm tired. But I explained to him the story. And I'm, you know, I'm like, I'm from Scotland, but I grew up in America. That explains the accent. So he drives me, and the universal kindness of people gets me out of that sticky situation. And I begin my trip. And I have a wonderful time. It's a great time exploring. I travel all over Scotland up to the Highlands, talk to lots of different people. And then one day, I'm walking through the streets of Edinburgh, you know, with my cheese and onion sandwich, feeling like I'm really Scottish. And I realize I'm exploring this foreign place. Everything is new to me. I thought I was going to come here and feel at home, like there would be this familiar feeling to me. I loved it, don't get me wrong, but it didn't quite fit like I thought it would. You know, I had that similar feeling that I had in America that didn't quite fit. So then the strangest things happen. I start to miss home in Ukraine. I know. I start to miss the familiarity of it. You know, my walk to school, you know, going to the bazaar to get, you know, my vegetables from my regular lady. And, you know, I realized that over my year in Ukraine, I've created this new home for myself. I can speak the language, so. You know, enough to get around anyway. You know, I have my own apartment. I have my friends. I've created a new home for myself. And even though I was in this place I was convinced was my true home, I was ready to come back to Ukraine. I missed my home in Ukraine. It was very, very strange for me. And sometimes, even though none of them quite fit, you know, I have my home in America, I have my home in Scotland, now I have my home in Ukraine. And even though none of them feel quite right, you know, I love them all, and they all mean a lot to me. And I still hope one day I will be somewhere that I feel a little more comfortable, a little more settled. But for now, I feel very lucky to have three different places that I can call home. And now whenever I encounter people that maybe think some of these differences are weird, I like to think of them as unique and showing my all the opportunities I've been giving and all the luck I've had to travel the world. So, thank you.